familiar with the concept of entities and chatbots, and in this video, we'll now show you how to build custom entities in an Oracle Intelligent Bot. Thanks for watching. My name's Grant Ronald from the Oracle Mobile Platform team. So you know that custom entities are the domain-specific nuggets of variable information that you want to pick out of your user's input and use in some way. A bank account type, a pizza size, a destination airport, for a travel booking bot. These are all common examples. Now, at the time of recording this video, there are four different ways of building custom entities in Oracle Intelligent Bots. And you can combine and reuse these custom entities to build quite powerful hierarchies of entity resolution in your bot. The four are a value list, which is an entity based on a list of possible values, derived, which is an entity derived from a base entity, but with a specific preceding or following phrase, an entity list, which is just a list of other entities, and a regex, which resolves an entity based on a regular expression. So let's have a look at each of these in turn. So a value list entity is simply an entity that's defined by an enumerated list of values. Now let's imagine that I need to understand if the user specifies an airport when booking a holiday. In this case, I'd create a value list entity called airport code, which contains a list of airport codes. So this means if the user asks, I want to book a flight to JFK, we automatically have JFK assigned to an entity variable. Now our airport example is an interesting one because whilst knowing the airport code is important for the booking, the user might specify both the departure airport and the destination airport in the same sentence. So they might say, I want to book a flight from LHR to JFK. Now a list entity would identify both LHR and JFK, but it would treat them the same, which isn't what we want in this case. We need to know the departure and the destination of the airport. And this is where we use a derived entity. So a derived entity is simply an entity which is based on an existing entity, but with a specified preceding or following phrase or words that distinguishes it from the entity in which it's derived. So in the travel example, depart airport is a derived entity based on airport code. So it's basically a list of airports. However, depart airport has a preceding phrase of from, meaning that depart airport is only going to resolve if the airport code is preceded by the word from. And this is our criteria for a departure airport. For the destination airport, we create a destin airport derived entity, which is derived from the airport code also. But in this case, the preceding phrase is to. So now when the user inputs, I want to book a flight from LHR to JFK, depart airport will be set to LHR and destin airport will be set to JFK. And it's worth mentioning that you can have a number of different key phrases. So depart airport might include preceding phrases such as flying out of or leaving from, etc. So let's see these two in action in a very quick demo. So let's create a new entity here. And we'll give this entity a name. In this case, it's going to be airport code. And this is a value list, so we've got that selected already. And we'll just have a list of values. So a list of airport codes, LHR for London Heathrow. Let's add JFK. And the last one, LAX. So that's us created an entity that's based on a list of values. Let's create another entity now. And we'll call this one depart airport. And this is going to be a derived entity. So it's derived based on airport code with a preceding rule of a phrase from or maybe departing or leaving. Okay, so the next entity type is one called an entity list. And as you might imagine, that's simply an entity that's resolved based on a list of other entities. Now, what's the use case? Returning to our travel example, what if people refer to their travel destination maybe in different ways? So rather than saying, I want to book a flight to CDG, they say, I want to book a flight to Paris, which is probably more likely, to be honest, in the case of Charles de Gaulle Airport. Although other cities such as New York, they're actually well known by their airport codes. in this example, JFK. Okay, we want to be able to capture a travel departure or a destination, whether the user refers to it by city, airport name, or airport code. And this is a use case where you could use an entity list. So back to our travel example, we currently identify a destination airport based on airport codes only. However, if I were to introduce a new entity called location, and location is an entity which is based on three value list entities, airport codes, airport names, and then cities. And then we make depart airport and destination airport derived from location. It now means that the user requests to book a flight from Paris to JFK. We can correctly resolve the departure point is Paris and the destination is JFK. Okay, and our final example is an entity based on a regular expression. Now, where might you use this? So let's look at three examples. There's tracking an order, there's checking some information based on a government tax code, or the status of a support ticket. Now, in each case, the key information, once the intent has been resolved, is the order number, the tax code, and the support ticket. And these all have a mix of numbers, letters, and special characters. And in the case of a tax code in the UK, we have what's called a national insurance number, which is a unique set of characters and digits that adheres to a specific format for identifying a UK taxpayer. So by creating an entity NI number, I can select regular expression and then define the sequence of characters that identify a national insurance number. So when the intent is resolved, the entity will be resolved based on this regular expression. So there you have it, a dive into the details of how you can build some quite powerful entity resolution features within Oracle Intelligent Bots. Thank you very much for watching.